Welcome to the third and final part here as we look at the Advanced Parliamentary Procedures, CDE, and what these rules will look like for the activity for 2021. And obviously, on all both these events, go back to the CDE manual. So anything I say in here, if I misspeak, I apologize. But the CDE manual would obviously be the gospel on this. So as we mentioned before, we're doing the national format differences. There's no team activity. There's no written test. So we're just talking about the activity itself. This team is doing their demonstration for parliamentary procedure. And in the advance, it is different than the beginning in that there's a little bit different motions involved. We're using our list that we've always used in Oregon. And there's no opening or closing ceremony. It just goes. They've got to make some more motions. They've got to debate more than the beginners do as we take a look at that. So what's it going to look like? You're going to notice right away, again, it's just one team and they're presenting together. So your chair is chairing their fellow chapter members, and you do have a person in the secretary station, although there's no minutes to turn in on this. And all six of these students have a card that tells them the main motion is going to be brought up. And they have their assigned motion, at least for five of them that are here, and it runs. And so just like we mentioned, there's a premise there. Each of those students that's on the floor, those five, will need to make their assigned motion, okay? They will each need to also make one other motion from the permissible list, so the ones we've always allowed in there. And so that means they've got some choice there. They are not limited to just those ones that are on the card. They will also be able to make additional motions. And then for full points, each member debates up to four times. On this, I think max, but actually that's a typo there. They can debate up to four times, but I think it's a top three that are actually scored is how that works. So again, check the CD manual on that one. Here's an example card. One thing is, you look for examples online, know that at National FFA, they use the full list of motions, the 20 plus, I think there's 23, 24, that are in Robert's Rules of Order. We're not. We're only using the motions we've always taught, which are the core ones, the most common ones. So if you see things like object to the consideration of a question, like we'll see here in a video in a second, we don't do that one. So you don't need to worry about that. Just know as you look for examples, you're gonna find a few things like that. This video is embedded in this slide deck. The slide deck's shared with everyone via Google Drive. Not gonna play it here because it doesn't play very well in screen capture. But here again, just from video one, here's a list of permissible motions. The ones we've always taught or been able to have in our competition, those are the ones that are now available to our students again with this. Again, another example card here. It'll even tell them what type of motion usually is, and they'll be highlighted which one is theirs. And again, this one, these first four are ones that we normally can make. Recess is not one that actually is in the Oregon Advanced. Also, at the end of their demonstration, each student will be asked a question. There might be follow-up clarifying questions. The question might have a couple parts, but I wouldn't expect that this year. And it'll be about parliamentary procedure, usually about the motion they were assigned. So if this one student is assigned to postpone indefinitely, they might get the question, if a motion is postponed indefinitely, when, if ever, may the same motion be renewed? And the answer, the correct answer, would be at any later session. So not this session, but a later session. You can see examples from the last several years on National FFA and the resources, and those are linked here at the end of this PowerPoint. Here's the scorecard. So this is like, oh my gosh, you look at this and you're like, what the heck's going on? Well, you break it down and it's not too bad. And so here are five students that are on the floor, right? Well, they're each assigned a motion. So they get 10 points for making that motion correctly. And so this box would be what their motions were. Here's the points for that. And then their discussion is here, 60 points max per member, 20 points max per item. So that means they can debate three times, get 20 points each, and then they would get the total there. But they can debate a fourth time and get additional points on there and to help reach that 60-point mark there. So they can debate each motion two times max. Again, that's Robert's Rules of Order. You can't debate a motion more than twice under Robert's Rules. Each person can't. And so they can get up to two times they can debate a main motion. Two times they can debate postpone indefinitely, the amend, the refer, a definite postponement, or to bring back. And so their points are kept there by the judge, and you'll total up their total when you're done here. And it can't exceed 60. They'll also make an additional motion that's on here. And when making that motion, doing it correctly would be 10 points per person. And then when they debate, again, debate is scored right here in the middle. Their question at the end were 16 points. And so individually, the student across here is worth 96 points when we look at everything they can do. The chair gets 65 points in their ability to preside. That's here because they don't show up in these top five. They'll get a score for leadership. That's here. And the chair gets a question worth 20 points. That's there. So that chair is worth 100 points during the session on here. You have a team effect score, and that's 20 points that are there. And so you work your way across. One thing that does not apply to us, the exam. There will be no exam score for Oregon for this year. And so that is not a problem. There's also no the research. Deductions are kept down here, and then time is kept here. There's a deduction for going over 11 minutes on there. And again, refer to the CD manual for any clarifying questions, this brief overview. Our goal here is just to take a look at it and realize, hey, you know what? After an initial review that might look a little complicated, we realize that this is pretty straightforward, and we can definitely handle this, and simpler than our current scorecard. So again, our students will know the hierarchy of motions. They'll know how to properly stage motion. They'll be able to think on their feet and debate these. The topics that don't apply. So what we normally would research, not this year. These topics, these main motions, which are predetermined, every team will have the same exact main motion, but you don't know what it is until you walk into the Zoom room, I guess, and it pops up in front of you. And you have a minute to think about it, and then we roll. And so level playing field there. And these topics, as you've seen, are all ones that can be debated, and just because they're in the basic FFA realm in terms of things like fundraisers to community service to career preparation, whatever sort of things might come up at an FFA chapter meeting. As you prep this team, teach your motions, get that debate flowing, coach them on that debate, get efficient, get effective at it. Each member is going to debate four times in a session, which is going to be at least three. Let's say that each three. That means you have 15 rounds of debate and you're going to have 10 different motions made in 11 minutes. We're going to be hustling. And so that's good. It moves it faster. It'll be more exciting. It'll be more interesting and engaging. And there'll be a learning curve, and your kids will be slow at start. That's absolutely how it's going to go. Trust me. Been there, done that. They'll get better. And they'll become more efficient. And they'll become working through it more as we do it. There's example cards. I've mentioned the thing to be aware of is the fact that not all cards will work for us because not all those motions apply to Oregon for 2021, but they're all out there and you can easily modify those. Links are here. This link works. It's just not green like the other. Sorry. So if aesthetics bother you, you're freaking out right now. But we've got the past resources. We've got Dunbar's list. You can check out the ones just for Parley Pro. He also has different ones for conduct of chapter meeting. And then the handbook is there. So with these things in mind, approach this with the possibility that our students can be more creative. They can actually debate against each other a little bit more and go back and forth, which doesn't seem to always happen in our final results. So have fun with this. And start with those silly topics and work your way into some more realistic ones. And maybe you'll have great conversations about things you could actually do in your chapter. And what if we actually saw better engagement and willingness to speak up at a chapter meeting? That'd be pretty cool. Reach out with other questions from people who have experience. And again, once you realize you get into this, very doable. And we're not going to be perfect at our district level. We're probably not going to be perfect at the state level. It's just going to be a matter of practicing and doing it and getting used to this, and we'll be good to go.